The dream is over.
Civil War sees an Elijah Longstreet in its embrace in the year 1862. Preceding that, he had served in the 2nd Corps Army of North Virginia under General Thomas Jonathan Stonewall Jackson. Elijah was loyal gray until the Battle of Canterlily. That's when he got the word, abandoned war, and was born again the Prophet Longstreet. A year later, standing bare, the Ponca chief and only remaining holdout of the Native American tribes laid down arms before the strong man of the Lakota. Red Cloud became chief of chiefs. There was smoke, oral histories, and Collison, and an endless Indian nation came to be. Soon the Union found itself fighting a war on two fronts. Righteousness and tyranny, and the resulting quagmire suited their hypocrisy. Conflict drug on until finally reaching a protracted lull a decade later. A war that was not war, lasting 20 more years until the fire in the sky. There are those that say the comet should have struck some other land, that God, like Joshua and the Armides, somehow held the world up, kept it from spinning, just so he could deliver judgment. Divine intervention or not, that event marked the end of hostilities, the remarking of territory, and formation of what would become the Seven Nations of America. The Accords were signed at Armistice, the epicenter of the event, on November 9th, 1908. It was significant, historic, and the third most important thing to happen that day. As in Atlanta, the Prophet Longstreet penned the second book of Revelation. And in Cherokee, Red Cloud shared a waking vision with his council of elders. Then upon completion, and by all accounts at the exact same time, both men collapsed and died. The words spoken and the words written down, interlocking apocrypha, collectively called by believers a message, remained an incomplete, unsolvable mystery for half a century, until the day it was completed. On his deathbed in New Shanghai, the exiled Chinese leader chairman, Mao Zedong, penned an addendum to his little red book, his portion, the missing portion of the message, the three were one. And the one? It was the story of the world's end.
Then there was a lone man, a broken sparrow.
What a part, a son of night. The first of four, the end of everything. And so I have arrived.